Now you're gonna miss out on the G-Funk era. You don't know how things are going for RNG. Him soon turn superstar.
11-10-70, that was my intro. But now I'm making dough, I'm rolling a 6-4. But things get shady where the grass is green. Brothers throwing up sets and hoods like they never seen her. Young Mac Daddy do his thing cause I pack right. I got 44 ways to make you act right. And it's a shame how the game must be played. It was told never fold by the brothers, you can't fade. So raise up off this young hog. Cause I heard you punking some, but you can't punk me, dog. I got my own thing cause I let my beat swing. If you wanna bring it on, no pain. No
gang. Warren G is the hottest new artist on Def Jam and the best producer I've met probably ever, maybe ever. And G-Funk Records probably is positioned like right now to be like on its own as big as Def Jam by itself. And I'm watching it grow.
I'm being true. Ain't no faking with me. Brothers plotting on me, trying to test if they can see. But I'm
hear a lot of Warren's influence in the production elements, as well as the rhyming styles, where people really got into a feel for what G-Funk was all about. And obviously here in Los Angeles and California as a whole, it is what hip-hop is these days. This is what it's become, is G-Funk.
G-Funk era is big time. It's coming up big time with the Twins, which is coming out in July, and then Dub Shack in August.
They decided to take funk and merge it with hip-hop and then take it to another level.
I'm hearing a lot about Warren's new label, G-Funk Music, and I'm definitely looking forward to all the music that's coming off of that, so because it's been strong. He's a great artist, so we can't wait.
Shit, we're getting ready to tear this motherfucking place up. Yeah. Whip
I think the Twins do something different than rap. The Twins call their stuff conversation.
We call it conversation.
We not gangster rappers, we conversators.
And basically, if you know the Twins, what they do on wax is no different than what they do when you're talking to them.
We knew Warren from, like, youngster. Us, Warren, Snoop, Nate Dogg, we all grew up together, so it was like, we knew him for a long time, and when he finally got his little thing going, he knew we was rapping too, so he's like, whenever I get my chance, I'm gonna bring y'all up, or if y'all get the chance, bring me up. It was just like that, so, flat out, how you like me now?
We're chilling behind the scenes at this Warren G video shoot. It's called So Many Ways.
Stay true to the gang, but some stay blind to the fact that if I don't look good, you don't look good. So please rearrange and change.
I met Warren G at a radio station in LA here. I was doing a guest thing. He told me about this DJ battle he was having, a nationwide DJ search because he needed a DJ. Did pretty good. I guess Warren liked it. About all 1,000 people there liked it.
That we caught the funk. Cause
we're here checking out the video in so many ways. We're getting ready to dip to Europe.
Up, up, and away.
So we out.
The music that he's doing is not considered as local hits, national hits and stuff. So when you can make a product and it sells all over, you know, that's something special, and especially in the rap market.
Well, when Warren G first came out, after just like a couple plays, it was like number one request. It blew out the phones in like top five for months after we started playing it.
It spawned a whole bunch of copycats, if you will, but Warren G was the one who really did it the best. Following up Regulate with this DJ, which obviously worked really well for us, and we're still playing those records today.
It's kind of easy when you listen to the G-Dub sound. Pioneer speakers bumping as I beat on a pound. I got the sound for your whip, and it's easy to see that this DJ be Warren G.
Well, me, Snoop, and Warren always been a group from way back in the olden days, you know what I mean? We started off G-Funk music back in the day, so we still here around the day.
Now they got the freaks, and that's a known fact. Before I got jacked, I was on the same track. Back up, cause it's on N-A-T-E and me, the woman to the G.
G-Funk music consists of Warren G, myself, the twins,
boy, I grew in.
Give them back and tell her what fun I had with the one time plus my mission. He's mad cause he missed it. Ain't no thing, it was a job and adventure. Could've got twisted tonight, but I got
richer. And also we're gonna release Round and Round, which is a major video.
We just doing our thing straight up. So G-Funk is every funk, you know what I'm saying? Just mixed into one, just how you bring it out.
Their rhythm is a little bit different because it's that old school flavor mixed with hip hop and a lot of slick lyrics, a lot of slick melodies, and a lot of original music.
The Twins record is the bomb, but the only way you're gonna find out is go buy it, so go get one.
Making millions, you know me, I'm the one that I always make a paper, but for now I'ma slide and listen to the women as they say.
G-Funk era, I mean, what isn't there to say? You know, they just smooth, you know, that's all G-Funk era is, just smooth, dope beats, and you know, I just think that they keep on doing what they're doing now, they're gonna be in the rap business for a long time.
You don't understand it, we're demanded and commanded and summoned. Here we're coming, let's start running.
Oh, the Bob Ross said, sipping on a little pink OG.
We at Studio Cat in Hollywood trying to get this album done.
You know, we got a lot of fat ones, man. A lot of fat.
Bomb drop.
Fatter than the engineer.
All of them are fat, really. Me and Scoop been together since we was young. And Bo Rock, we just hooked up with him about a good 2 years ago.
We got hooked up through my homeboy Warren G. You know what I'm saying? G-Funk Era, much props and shit.
Yeah, Warren G's Regulate G-Funk Era. Number 9 on the CD. This is the Shaq. We put it down on this album. That got us to where we at now. Not much love for Warren G.
As you enter into the zone called the G.
Boy, wake up when I'm talking to y'all fools. See, that's why it ain't gonna be no summertime in the LBC for y'all.
Yeah. This is C-Night from the Dove Shack. Getting dough shit out. Kicking it at King's Park with all the homies. You know what I'm saying? So won't you check out my homie Bo to the Rock.
I ride with her. I slide with her.
I'm Brett Ratner, the director of the new Dove Shack video, Summertime in the LBC. This is like a house party barbecue, grandpa's house. We're at grandpa's house.
Hadn't been for your mama, drunk ass, we wouldn't have ever had you three niggas.
And you could tell the house is kind of like roach and beat up and broken down. But in the backyard is the Dove Shack. That's fly, that's got leopard and girls and smoke and drink and everything for everyone. So you'll see, and they're going to perform on top of the roof of the Dove Shack during a barbecue in the back.
We had our video shoot, chilling and shit, masks, skirts.
This is C-Night from the Dove Shack. I'm just chilling at the video shoot, getting dope.
Two Scoop, Eastside, Long Beach riding.
This is me going down this summer. And, you know, we finna take over. I'm sorry, you know what I'm saying? The
bomb. I was working at Def Jam West as Barack came in one day and asked me, hey, can you really sing? And I said, yeah, I can. And then he goes, okay, we're going to go in the studio tomorrow and cut the song.